aren't they the same hands? Maybe it's ambidextrous. Fine. Alrighty. We good? We live?
Not on Facebook.
Okay, I'll wait. Did you fix the mic or is it?
Is it already good? Nope.
Already good. Alright. You live?
Nope.
Do you have to stop streaming?
Yep.
Okay. Let me know when I'm good to go.
Go ahead.
Are we good? We live on everything?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Oh. Crap. They're in the wrong hand. Who's this? Well, hello there, guy. Is that him? I guess I don't really know much about the Unabomber. I know I watched, like, a Netflix thing, like, one episode that my friend was watching. Is that our guy? Is that who we're looking for? Yo, can I have your shades, dude? No. No? I don't know. Eh. Are you clicked on the game, Addy? There we go. Now I got sound. Look at all this stuff.
It takes cooperation, dedication, and innovation to solve a tough case, and the Unabomber case was one of the toughest. An elusive criminal waged a 17-year campaign of terror with lethal homemade
bombs. Was it
really
bombs, that long?
Starting in 1978 with universities and airlines, that's how the suspect was named. The Unabomber had injured 23 and killed 3 people by 1995. Catching the killer was the FBI's top priority.
95? Before I was born. Investigation.
I'm Terry Turchi, the FBI agent in charge of the Unabomber investigation. Welcome to the task force headquarters here in the San Francisco field office of the FBI. I'll be your boss as we try to solve one of the toughest criminal cases in U.S. history.
Cool.
It will require all of your investigative skills and a new approach to fighting terrorism. We've set up an 800 number. We've offered $1 million reward. We've teamed up with ATF and Postal Inspection Service investigators. Check out the case wall. This will get
Holy
you up
shit.
To speed.
That's a lot of money. I wish I had that much money. I could do so much stuff with that money.
We'll need a break to put all these pieces together.
Sketch. I already looked at that. What do we got on here? So these are all the places that he hit. Michigan on there. Nope. Oh, right there. Ann Arbor, Michigan. Huh. The University of Michigan. I did not know that. Learning something new every day. Wow, he was all over. When was that?
Tiny Rick!
In 85. Holy crap. That seems like it was so long ago, and I wasn't even there, because I wasn't even born yet. Alright.
You better check that message.
Okay.
This is the New York Times calling. We have something you need to see.
Manifesto. What does that even mean?
Take a step.
You're in the publisher's office of the New York Times. They just received a letter from the Unabomber saying that if a national news publication prints the manifesto he wrote on the evils of technology, he'll stop killing people. The Times could have published the manifesto without asking, but they called us first. What should we do? Suggest they publish the manifesto or refuse the killer's demands?
We don't do terrorism here. We're like manatees, the only mammal with no fear of.
Yeah, I know
terrorism.
It seems risky, but we recommended publishing the manifesto. Not because we believe the Unabomber's promise, but because we hope someone might recognize the writing and provide the lead we need. Let's go back to San Francisco and see what happens.
Okay.
The Washington Post published the manifesto in September 1995. The New York Times shared the cost, and we waited. 5 months later, we got the call we needed. A man named David Kaczynski and his wife had seen the manifesto and thought it sounded a lot like David's brother. Thousands of people had called the 800 number. More than 50 of them told us the Unabomber might be their brother. This time it's different. David gave us a 23-page essay written in 1971, as well as letters from his brother, Ted Kaczynski, and there were similarities to the Unabomber's manifesto. Here, take the magnifying glass, compare the passages from the manifesto to Ted's writings.
All right. New York Times. This is a message from...
Right. Pretty similar. He used a common phrase in both documents. You can't eat your cake and have it too. But he got the phrase backward in both cases. That is more than a coincidence. That helps us narrow down our list of more than 2,000 suspects. It looks like we need to focus our attention on Theodore Kaczynski, Unabomber suspect number 2,416.
Oh, wow. Look at all the peoples. Use the trigger to pick up. Who's this guy? The cabin.
David told us about his brother's cabin near Lincoln, Montana. We arrested Ted there on April 3, 1996. But we need to gather evidence from the cabin to prove he was the Unabomber.
1996, that was a year before I was born.
Interesting. A witness from one of the bombings said the suspect wore a hoodie.
Is there a hoodie somewhere? Oh, there's a hoodie.
Look at that. A bomb underneath Kaczynski's cot. If that goes off, we'll lose everything.
Oh, well.
It's a good thing we worked with bomb experts to develop a special robot to help us disarm Unabomber devices. Try steering the robot.
How do I steer it?
Carefully pick up the hot bomb and take it outside.
I just gotta hold it. That's it. I wish I could actually control it. Just gotta hold it. Just holding the trigger. He's like the Hurt Locker, but with robots.
Good work. Now, let's see what we can find in the cabin.
Yo, see, he started the Tide trend first, right here. He was already eating Tide. Oh, they really use Tide to make bombs? Like, what's in it that makes bombs? Interesting. Handmade pistol. Huh. It's a little small. What do you even shoot out of that thing? It's like a BB gun. Ingredients to make bomb. The paint? I don't know how to make a bomb, so I don't know what any of these ingredients would be. Oh, the sunglasses in the sketch. Ah, I did get his sunglasses. No! I guess I can't wear them. What else is in here? I don't want to look at that yet. And look at all this other stuff. It's back here. Those are cool guns. That one needs to be refinished. It's a little sketchy. A little worn out. What's this? I can't pick up anything else. Lame. What is this thing? Huh. Wilderness survival. Electronics made simple. Well, I guess you would have to have that to make bombs. We'll learn how. The French Revolution. Conflict and interpretations. Hey, he's got some Quaker oats. What else we got over here? Golf wax. Oh, he's got an extra pair of shades just in case the other ones break. Hershey cocoa. So that was pretty cool. He's got a lot of, he reads a lot, for sure. What is this thing? Oh, it's like a harp kind of thing, I guess. I guess, I don't know what that is. Don't know what kind of instrument. It's got strings though.
Bingo. This is the actual typewriter on which the manifesto was written.
Corona.
Corona's responsible!
Are these all the guys that died? Or are these the people who are working on the case?
The evidence you gathered helped put Ted Kaczynski away for life. Publication of the Unabomber's manifesto
was
the break we needed. Some people disagreed with the decision to publish, but the Unabomber investigation bucked many FBI traditions. To solve the case, we needed a maverick approach. A few years later, after the September 11, 2001 attacks on America, the FBI continued to adopt new techniques to battle terrorism and continues to depend on public support to get the job done.
Like, hear everything we say.
As the Unabom case demonstrated, together we can win this fight.
Well, that was short. What do we got in extras? All this stuff. Pick up to investigate the cabin. Already did that. Already did the interview. Case. What is this?
Give us just a brief overview of the Unabomber. What were some of his targets and some of his motives that we later learned?
Well, that's what made it so difficult to identify a suspect, was because the Unabomber, it became very clear early on, had to be a lone wolf. He was not talking to anyone, or else something would have come to light in less than 16, 17 years.
You want to grab me a chair, man?
His early targets were against university professors, graduate students, bombs sent through the mail to specific professors, as well as bombs placed in the corridor outside of computer room, University of Utah. And that was repeated in
yeah,
other locations as well,
here.
University of California. And then there was early on, I think his third bombing was against the American Airlines flight. A mailed bomb was placed on there with a rigged altimeter that was, a barometer was used and rigged to be an altimeter to explode at a certain altitude.
Huh.
And it did detonate, it did ignite a fire, but it didn't explode, so it was saved the lives of all the people on that plane. But even so,
well,
the pilot recognized that smoke was coming into the cabins, and he did an emergency landing at Dulles Airport, saving people's lives. But so airlines and universities were the early targets, and so the FBI has a propensity for acronyms. So we did UN for University, A for aircraft, and bomb, of course. So it became Unabomb, and then the Unabomber just as a moniker that stuck.
Huh. There's more to every story. Let's see what else we got.
got the help of the media in by publishing it, and then I did numerous press conferences talking about, well, remember what we know about the Unabomber. We know the area, geographical areas that he's worked in, and so urging the public to come forward. And there was a $1 million reward that had existed for a few years in a 1-800 telephone line that people were calling in their potential suspects. People, ex-wives were reporting their husbands. like 52 or 54 brothers reported their brothers were the Unabomber. And of course, that we were just looking for that one tip that would be the one that made good, and that is what happened.
And that's exactly where I was going to lead to. Tell us about that tip.
Max, you want to talk about how that?
And then Max, I want to talk about the zeroing in on him too. But
no, the we got a call,
Max,
from an attorney who was brokering, trying to broker a deal with us about a client that he had. And he was a Washington, D.C. attorney. And it just, things don't happen like they appear to have happened. This attorney had a good working relationship with an FBI agent here in Washington, D.C. He was no longer here. He was in South Carolina. So he contacted him in South Carolina. He, in turn, said, well, I'm not there. I'll give you an agent in D.C. to contact. So he did. And this young lady, agent named Molly Flynn, met with him and got a 20-page or 21-page document to read, and it was typed on an antique typewriter. We had one forensic piece of evidence that we were always searching for, and it was an antique Smith Corona 1925-30 typewriter with Pica-style type, 2.5 horse spacing. That's the one thing that connected all of these cases together over the years. So Molly got it, took it to the laboratory, our laboratory. They examined it and said, no, it's not that typewriter. So they sent it back to Molly. And Molly was a good agent. She knew how massive this case was. This case was not the normal case. If you ask about the Unabomber file was 59,000 volumes of information.
Holy
that translates
crap.
Over 11,800,000 pages of documents. And she knew that. And so she called out to another supervisor on the Unabomber case, Joel Moss, and she told him she had this document, she was sending it, but she didn't want it to get lost in all of that stuff that was coming in. She said, pay attention to it, because even though the typewriter isn't the same one, the ideas here are exact to the ideas in the manifesto. So Joel got it and read it and got excited. And he took it to Terry and to our psychologist that was on the task force, an agent, and they got excited. And Terry and Jim were going to lunch, and they took it to Terry, and Terry said, oh my God, we need to talk about this. So he canceled his meeting with Jim, gave him some lame excuse that he couldn't go with him, and we went to lunch together with that document. And as we're having lunch and reading the document, who walks in but Jim? And he kind of looked at Terry and said, ah, nah, you know. So anyway, everyone got real excited about it. And the minute he read it, he got excited. And we went back up, and Terry talked to him, and Jim said, this is the man. This is the Unabomber. We're turning the ship, and we're going. We had 2,417 actual suspects, not just people of interest, but actual suspects. So he was very perceptive.
But this
in
document was it 1973 that it dated, that it was written?
1971.
That was a treatise that Ted Kaczynski had written and had given to his brother, and his brother David had kept that. And when you read those pages from that many years before and compared it to a reading of the manifesto, I came to the conclusion the same person wrote it, and others did as well. You can't take that to the bank. I mean, that does not get you a federal search warrant or a federal warrant. He has a lot more work to be done than that. But the gut feeling was there, and we started a linguistic study and started developing common phrases and as well.
Oh, I hit it? Oh, well, we'll move to the next one. History, investigation of the Unabomber.
Talk a little bit about 2014. The pressures that you felt.
One of the saddest things that happens is when you're all assembled and you really think you have a great plan, and then someone else gets killed. And that happened to us in 1995, and it happened to us in 1994. While all of this was coming together and while we thought we were making a difference, And you can see the morale of people just kind of start to dip. And you go home every night. Max and I commuted. We actually commuted from where we live in the East Bay over to San Francisco. And while everybody else chose their partner, we kind of became partners. And we kept each other's morale up, because on those moments and on those days, of course, people back here, because it's their job, they're the phones are ringing off the hook. The media has its own spin. The families and the victims of the families are on the phone, or they want to talk to you. And you do. I mean, we went and sat down with people. And what do you say? I remember the Epsteins. Dr. Charles Epstein lived in Tiburon. And he was a Unabom victim in 1993. And I remember that John Conway, who was the first case agent for Unabom, took me out to meet the Epsteins. And we sat in their living room. And the apprehension of just going in there, they were one of the first families I'd ever met when I started doing this. And we sat down, and it was not at all what I expected. And I think from that point on, this is what really got us through the days. They sat there, and they were more worried about me and whether or not I was getting enough sleep than they were about what had happened to him. And as Max and I and Jim dealt with these families and the victims, over the years, they were all that way. And in the darkest days, when you would expect that they're going to be pretty upset, they would be sitting down with you and saying, you got to make sure you stay focused and stay rested and know that we have confidence in you. So it's hard to convey how you feel, but I'll tell you, I know how I think everybody feels today that's looking at the world and is responsible for being on the front lines of counterterrorism. I think you worry a lot. I think you work long hours. And it's very, very difficult to put it down, because we used to say, and I know they still say, that, you know, like if you're a baseball player and you bat 500, you're just about the greatest in the world. The FBI, the CIA, we cannot afford to bat 500, and we can't afford to bat 900, because one person out of 100 getting through can be not just a tragedy, but perhaps going forward, could literally affect the sovereignty of our country. That's how serious the problem of terrorism became, and that's how we took this when we spent the days together. In 1993, the Unabomber surfaced after a number of years of absence, no bombs, and sent a letter to the New York Times, essentially portraying the Unabomber as the terrorist group FC, giving a number, a secure number that the New York Times would have, and the FBI would eventually have. And they would know that if there are further communications from the Unabomber, they would know that they are authentic because of this coded number. And the New York Times came to the FBI immediately with that information, never delayed a moment. And so I think that almost set us off on a very good road together from June of 1993. We never did learn what FC stood for, and interestingly, we did not spend a lot of time on the Unabom task force trying to figure that out.
Huh. All right, the rest. This is pretty cool. Like, it's interesting. I never knew about, I knew of the Unabomber.
In 1993, the Unabomber surfaced
after a
number
of
years of absence.
Looking at already.
No bomb.
But yeah, I knew what the Unabomber was, but like I didn't know how long it went or anything like that.
In 1993, the Unabomber surfaced after a number of years of absence.
Hey, come on.
No bomb.
Cherry. You don't want to start up?
In 1993, the Unabomber surfaced after a number
Try
of
this
years.
One. No.
In night.
All right. Well, we'll go back to. Ooh. Who the heck am I? You know, always when you take off your headset, you have no idea where you are. All right. What do we got? What else we got? What are all these things? So I can look at all these. For the manifesto. Hmm. Oh, so that was his brother. Hey. I'll grab this one. That's what he looked like. Where's the sketch? I want to look at the sketch. No? They didn't want to put the sketch out here? Oh. This one? Hmm. Could use a little more beard on the sketch. Hmm. Interesting. What else we got? The envelope that he sent it in. Doesn't look like an envelope. Is that what they used to look like? Mailing package from Yale Bomb. Hey, it's got the Olympic rings on it. Reconstruction of the bomb. What is this? From the Forestry Association bombing? What is that? I don't even know what that is. Must have been like where the bomb went off. Hmm. What else we got? Sketch of the bomb? For what? When was this? Employee alert, authority, suspicious package mail. No, I don't know. The Barclays student, John Hauser, opens package in computer lab, lost four fingers. Holy crap. It's just like a firecracker if it's only four fingers. Well, I guess it would be a pretty big firecracker, but seems like it would deal more damage. Steph at Vanderbilt. Oh, Vanderbilt, that's where Justin Verlander went for baseball. If you guys know him, he was on the Detroit Tigers, and then he moved over to the Astros this year. College of Business at University of Utah. So where's, like, I want to see, like, the pictures of, like, where everything, like, of the explosions and stuff. End plug, like, to the bomb, I'm guessing. Pieces from the bomb. Packaging used to mail a bomb. Oh, the first sketch of the bomb. What is this? So they got a couple different sketches of, like, what it would look like. Unless these were, like, just all different ones. Illusion of a book. That's creative. See, I wonder, like, if all this stuff happened in today's world, how long it would take to get that person. Just from, like, all the different stuff that we've, you know, that they put in place now. You know, of, you know, like after 9/11 and stuff like that. I just wonder how long it would take. All right, I've pretty much looked at everything here. So let's go, let's see if there's anything else. Videos?
The Unabomber wrote us, the government was not telling us that we could publish or that we shouldn't publish. And I've got to tell you right now that in dealings with the FBI and with the Department of Justice, they were superb. They were superb. They told us what they knew. They told us what they didn't know. They walked that line very finely. And it was a wonderful experience in that regard. That we didn't put ourselves in a place where journalists and shouldn't be. We are not an arm of government. At the end of the day, we felt we were not doing that.
we felt that this was a decision that we were making on our own. The cost of newsprint was the only cost we had to bear. And when you put that against the cost in human life, it was a rather simple equation. They did ask that we publish this, making it clear that this was a request, and we agreed. This was not somebody who said, I will kill somebody if you don't publish this. This was somebody who had a track record of killing people, and this was an opportunity to stop that.
I was with another agent, Pat Webb. Pat was an explosives agent. So we opened the door just a bit to the cabin. And as we opened the door, we were both pretty much overcome. As we looked across the cabin at the shelves that were built on the other side of the door.
Pretty accurate.
We could see coffee cans and bottles and jars, and they all had labels on them, and they were very meticulously done. And we could see that some were labeled with the name of certain chemicals. One of the things we saw was a hooded sweatshirt, that was hanging up there. And the cabin smelled as if you might start to think, if you really think about this. This is a person who lived in this cabin. It had a cutaway spot in the floor to go to the bathroom in if he needed to.
Ew.
Built fires in the cabin. There was an old potbelly stove in there. So the smell of smoke was in everything. Pat Webb turns to me, and he has tears in his eyes, and one running down his cheek. And he said, this is it. We found the Unabomber. At long last, this is over.
Well, how many years was it again? I forgot how many years it was. It was a while, though. They said something like, it's like 19, what was it? It wasn't 50s, was it? I don't know, I don't remember. That's just, like, this stuff is so crazy. Like, how long it took. Watch these real quick. So it's just names.
The evidence you gathered helped put Ted Kaczynski away.
Oh, we already watched these, okay.
Publication of the Unabomber's manifesto was the break we needed.
Well, let me know. Do you want me to do...
Unabomber investigation.
I want to know what you guys want me to do.
To solve the case,
if you want me to look at something again,
years later,
let me know
September 11, 2001 attacks on America. The FBI
and Maddie, if you could let me know
techniques
when that pops up and see if anyone says anything.
Continues to depend on public support to get the job done. As the Unabomber case demonstrated, together...
Yeah, I know. We'll do follow-up. I just want to make sure, like, if anyone wanted to see anything...
Just
four people. Oh, it's Caden. Yo, what's up, dude? I see you're getting married. Oh, we're back in Michigan, too, so we'll have to hang out this summer up at the cabin.
Do you just want to do follow-up?
Yeah, we'll switch over to Fallout, and if anyone wants to see something, just let us know in the comments below, and we'll go back to it, and for you.
That's okay.
Switching over. Mm-hmm. Did you already start it up, or should I start it?
I started it.
Five hours and 31 minutes. We got a lot of time playing this so far. Where's the thing? Because now I can move it towards me. And I can see things.
Are we good?
Yeah.
You can hear stuff.
How do I? Oh, that's as close as I can get it. Lame. I can spin it too. Oop, supposed to load in. Alright. Where are we going? What's my objective? I don't even remember. It feels like so long ago, even though it was yesterday. Jewel of the Oh, go to Diamond City. Okay. Where am I at right now? Yeah, I'm just gonna go down and then go across that road. going? Okay, I'm going this way. This way! Oh, there's that thing again. What? Oh. Oi, hey! I missed his face. Wait a second. I don't even know. Where's my health at? I wasn't even paying attention. Alright, I should probably just... Oh, what are we gonna do? Alright, let's go to this. Where's my machete? Oh, where'd it go? There it is. Machete! Come here. Die! Oh, there we go. Okay. Where's... Yeah, give me that XP. It's over here. Oh, there's another one. Give me a weapon. I want to gun him down first before he comes down here. Where's my auto pistol? There we go. Die! Hey, you leave me alone. Dang, dude, you hurt. Apples and too much apples. Bam! Right in the face. Give me that. Hello, is there any more of you? I'm so happy that they have a radio in this game. It's so nice. Hello? No one around here? Where am I going again? Oh yeah, I'm going this way. Okay, I remember there's super mutants down there, and I'm only level 8, and they have rocket launchers, so I'm not going down there.
That was Tex.
Because it was just a bad time. You're gonna have a bad time. Come on. Okay, well, I'll go over here.
This is Diamond City Radio, and I'm, you know, it's me, Travis.
No!
This is a song about easy
play.
Living.
Alright, I'm gonna go around.
It's like here in Diamond City, am I right?
Well, I'm about to go to Diamond City, bro. I feel like I'm playing Skyrim, because I would never want to walk around the mountains. Hey! There we go. Ooh, what's this? Who's shooting stuff? No, it's just a tree. Well, that's a pretty high up place. Oh, what's this? Fielder's Green Trailer Estate. Look around, see if we can find anything. Oh! Cool. Damn landmines. Rooted perk. You can inflict and take more damage while standing still. And maybe even reflect some damage back. I need that perk, because I like melee weapons. Alright, so now we know we gotta go over here first. Go up and around a little easier. I wish I had better stamina though. Jeez.
That was Tex.
Normally I go for like the heaviest stuff, so like power armor and stuff like that. I get my science up. Get that core time increase.
This is Diamond City Radio, and I'm, this is me, Travis.
Alright, give me something with a suppressor. Oh, there's my tire iron blade.
Yep. Yeah,
that's what's up. I got a suppressor. Is that suppressed? No. Nope. Nothing with a suppressor. Cool. Where did my tire iron go? Come here, big boy. One swing. Got that duct tape. Hello? There's another one over there. Oh! Uh-oh! Oh, that guy hits hard! God dang! Alright, well, at least now I know he's in there. It kind of sucks, because I didn't save either. So I gotta run all the way back up that hill. Yeah, you know what, actually, I'm going to... Because a lot of these are a higher level than I am. So we're going to just teleport to here. Nope. I haven't been there yet. All right, well, we're going to go back up to this. Because I already cleared this place. Yeah, see, I'm only level 8. So I for sure need to level up before going over there. I could just wear my power armor, but I don't have enough cores to feel comfortable wearing it all the time. Because I've lost power armor before by not having enough cores. So, work on armor and stuff
that
anyways.
Text.
I never really
text.
Worked on armor.
Text.
I should. Where am I going? This way. I already cleared all this, so there shouldn't be anyone in here.
Coming to you from,
Oh, okay, I guess not.
The great green jewel of the Commonwealth. It's Diamond City Radio.
Right in the face.
Wynonie Harris had a grand
Twirl on a stick, table, my
I guess,
favorite.
So he wrote a song about it, and I'm not just talking about it. I intend to play it. So here it is.
I have cleared that place now, so I don't even have to worry about it. Can I go up this way? What up? I don't think I went in here, though. Let's see what's in here. See if there's any good stuff. Like, good? What we got? Yeah! I'll take that melon, too, actually. What, where do we got to go? I'm gonna stroll up here first. Because do I have to unlock this? No, I just open it. Okay. Because it looks like something important might be in here. Fire support. Listen to military frequency. Okay. I can do that. Just a bull run. Oh, that's empty. Wait, no, it's not. What up? Another medic. Oh, I'm over encumbered. I just need to get down to the, Diamond City, so I can start selling crap. Next time I find somewhere, I'm actually gonna pop in and go up to Sanctuary to drop some stuff off. Oh, that's right, because I am holding all this power armor. That's what's taking up all my weight. Cool Q, get rid of this. Crap. What is drop? There we go.
We got 15 minutes until mine.
Right. What else we got? That's worth kind of a lot. I mean, so is that, though. I'm good.
Hey, Grandma, did you get your numbers in yet? Well, that's it, son. Well, what did you play? 3, 6.
Okay, I'm going this way. Adventure! This will take care of them. Oh, there's a scorpion too? I didn't see him before. Actually, I want that hardened pistol. Where's it at? There we go. What did I pick up? Am I really overweight again? Oh, must have been because of something I ate that gave me more strength. All right. Well, I can do that. Do I have any alcohol? No? I got nothing for strength, do I? Oh, right there. Take one of them. Ooh. I don't like that. All right, we're gonna go to... my tire iron. And then, because this is probably way too high of a level for me too. Slows time for 10 seconds. Damage resistance, poison resistance. Bam. Right there, that's what I need. Come here. Is this supposed to be sexual? Is that why it's Rocket 69?
Probably.
Sure, we'll do this. Am I really overweight still? Wait. We'll drop them. Drop. Should be alright now. Where's my health? I don't even know where my health went. Must be full or something. Oh, I'm dead. Ooh, no. Guess not. Gotta weigh it up from it. Gunfire! I like gunfire. Oh, Getting attacked by zombies is what you love. Or ghouls, I should say. Hello, Tyler and Dan. Is it Dance or Dan? Yeah, it's Dance. Hey, come on. You stay away. Bad little ghoul, bad. Hello.
Hi. We appreciate the assistance, civilian. But what's your business here?
I prefer to keep my business to myself.
Then, if there's nothing left to discuss, I suggest you leave our compound immediately.
Don't tell me what to do. Hey, oi, hey.
Connie L.
Hey,
there with,
hey.
Dance?
You decided to cooperate and tell me what brought you here?
I'm just trying to survive out here, like everyone else.
The way you charged in and engaged those ferals, I find that a bit difficult to believe. Are you from a local settlement?
Do all these questions really matter? After all, I help you fight those ferals.
You make a fair point. Hey!
It's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth,
that guy looks like he's about to die. Fire.
If you want to continue pitching in, we could use an extra gun on our side.
Cool.
That all depends. How much are you paying?
We need allies, yeah. Not opportunistic mercenaries. I have no inclination to pay for your services.
I'll continue to help, but you owe me an explanation first.
Very well. I'm Paladin Dance, Brotherhood of Steel. Over there is Scribe Halen and Knight Reese. We're on recon duty. But I'm down a man and our supplies are running low. I've been trying to send a distress call to my superiors, but the signal's too weak to reach them.
Sir, if I may...
Proceed, Halen.
I've modified the radio tower on the roof of the police station, but I'm afraid it just isn't enough. What we need is something that will boost the signal.
Our target is ArcJet Systems, and it contains the technology we need. The deep range transmitter. We infiltrate the...
Here's a thing. A sort of note? I guess,
From I kind of walk away from him.
In Diamond City, and I'll,
okay, so I'm able to come back to here. So I'm just going to go to Sanctuary real quick and drop off.
Meat.
Oh, my crap.
Just meat. Stop asking if we have anything else.
I think I'm going to focus on weapon upgrades this time around instead of power armor. Because, like, look at that. I want that stuff. Oh, good thing it wore off after I traveled. Cause now I am full of crap.
Let's find out.
Come here.
What Danny Kay knows about civilization.
Store all junk. There we go. Where did I make my? Yeah, all my crap's here. So transfer.
Morning, a missionary of the kind.
Let's go to weapons. Don't need that. It's got 8 rounds. Whatever. Keep it. Get rid of that. Never know when you're gonna need those. Let's go. I'll keep that because I'm using it right now. Machete. Put the machete in there. I want to keep that just in case. We got quite a bit of rounds for it anyways. Put that away. Should I put that other one away? Now that I think about it. Don't really need it. It's only got 8 rounds. Don't have anything for that, so let's throw those in there. Do I have another 10mm in here? Maybe, maybe not. What does that use? There is a 10mm. Okay, that's just my one. Alright, so we're gonna drop all this crap in there. Put it on that later. Alright. I kind of want to put a turret here real quick. Didn't mean to do that, but sure. There we go. Alright, so what we're gonna do right quick, do defenses. Yeah, we're gonna do a one of these. Oh, I need to be a gun nut. Alright, well, I think I might be able to get that. Let's actually see. How do I go to stats? Level up. Woo! Gun nut. Where's gun nut? Gun nut. Alright. We're gonna do that. So now.
Have the sight. It has to be.
So we're just gonna right click.
Talk to the dead, kid. Even the sight has limits. I'm sorry.
We're gonna put one here. Actually, no, we're gonna put it like over here. Put that there. Also put this. I want it up there. What else we got? What does this do? Missile turret!
That Deathlong Conqueror was bad news, huh, Mama? You ever seen one of those suckers before?
Oh,
shotgun
sure.
Turret spotlight.
One time, I killed a Deathclaw. All by myself. No
drama,
no fancy minigun, just a pipe pistol. One bullet.
You telling me you killed a Deathclaw with
one
bullet?
Doubt.
Come on. What do you take me for?
Oh, I might not look it, but back in the day, I had quite the shot.
Yeah, or quite.
No one's getting in here to steal my crap. So I should probably build some beds and stuff too, because they kind of need some.
We're at 9 o'clock right now.
Alright. I'm going to play for a while, anyways. So. Well, let's go to the bedrooms, put these in there. I guess that would be the bedroom. There. Do that. Cool, we good on beds. Now what do we need to do? Some produce or something? I can like farm right here. I'm actually gonna come out here, farm some stuff and things. Can't remember. I can only place in dirt, so do I have to? Oh, there we go. Okay. Did I not plan anything else?
Hanging in there.
Alright. So let's see if I can do something about the water.
When you're at ground zero,
anyway, can I scrap that? Yeah, I'll do that. Can I not get one of these? Scrap it. Water purifier. Can I not? Let's look. See, I need some concrete. I got this. Oh, hello, doggo. We're gonna scrap it. Yeah, I got that concrete now. There we go. We're gonna just put this right on there. So we good on water? No? I don't think I can't do anything more with food, so. How do I exit out of this?
Seems to be growing well.
Okay, so now I gotta get back into my. Does it just not let me? Huh, weird. I gotta go all the way. I don't know what the quick button is for this.
Coming to you.
I hope you find your son.
The jewel green. I mean, green. The great green jewel of the Commonwealth. It's Diamond City Radio. Here comes Bing Crosby saying we should accentuate the positive. I guess that was easy if you were Bing Crosby.
Whew. Am I good on food now? Alright, I think I did alright for you guys, so.
One of these houses would be a good place to set up some beds.
I already set up the beds, bro. I want to actually. Foundation somewhere, actually. Probably make more sense. Oops.
When Madame Papa's door was on a ballroom floor, said,
yeah, okay. So, foundation. Can I scrap all this stuff?
And think of all the books about to bury.
Anything else? Can I move this? No.
Personality.
What did Romeo see in Juliet or Figaro in Pierrette or Jupiter in Juno?
Bam! Alright, so now we're gonna go back to show walls. I ran out of wood. Let's go tear some stuff down. Can I not scrap this? this scrapping. Oh look, there's a nice little foundation over there now. Cleaning up the whole area here. I wish I could like cut these weeds down. Give me a weed whip, I'll do it. Alright, so now we should be able to... Is this roofs? Do that. And also do... So I want a flat roof now. And I want another one of these right over there. Okay, so I'll do another flat one here. Got a little base coming along here. You got a doorway or something? See if there's any in the door. No, there's no door section. Is there a door section? Yes, there is. Do I have to do like a doorway? I think I have to do like a doorway. Hey! Don't come walking around here. Choices. I'll go with a screen door. Make it be a little porch. Yeah. That looks cool. Alright. So let's get out of this because now all my crap's protected. I think. Can I open this? Nope. I gotta exit. Exit. Yep, alright, we're all good in here now. Aw, crap. Well, that's not good. Workshop.
I'll try to make myself useful.
Shut up.
No one wants to see.
Alright,
Grown man feeling sorry for himself.
Then stop doing it.
Okay. Senator Davis, a name I still find confusing.
Alright, so we need a corner wall. Or something of that nature.
Coming to you from the jewel green. I mean,
bam.
The green. I mean the great green jewel of the Commonwealth. It's.
Oh, I leveled up again.
City
Woo!
Radio.
There we go. All so, set up and cozy and let's just, protected.
Let's do a song by the Three Sons.
So are we? Oh, I probably have a lot of miscellaneous crap on me again. Do I not have any junk? I wonder if it goes like straight. I think it goes straight into my whatever you call it. But I want to make sure my weight's all right. Yep, we all good. Close the door. Do, 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 do. Cool. Power armor. Even without any pieces, a power armor frame provides a variety of advantages like increased carry weight, greater melee damage, and the elimination of falling damage. Interesting. Alright. We're searching all these guys. Give me the bottle caps. Give me all your caps. Bottle caps and rounds. Oh wait, I want that duct tape for the adhesive. There we go. Yeah, so Prob's not doing their missions right now because I like wearing power armor in their missions because they get a lot of these ghouls. Oh, there's some up there too. Fusion cell. Actually, I'm gonna go up here because there's probably like some fusion cells and stuff of that nature. Yeah, see. Ooh, another melon. Holotag. Laser rifle, what up? What else we got in here? Anything else? So good. Already got everything. All right, where am I going now? Gotta go this way. What's this? Post 115. Should I go in there? Sure. Crouch before I go in. I probably should have saved before I went in too, but oh well. A quick save right when I get in. Boop. Oh, it's super mutants. I don't like that. Nope. Out. I'm out. Super mutants are too hard right now. Not high enough level. Unfortunate. Oh, is there literally someone like right here? Hello? There they are. Leave me alone. Of course they would have bases right next to each other, though. Oh, things. Who's that? Hey, what are you? What is you? Take these blocks. Spell something out later. Oh, great. The bridge is up. Oh, I remember this. Are these mutants? I don't remember. I just remember he has power armor. They saw me. What? Where's that spotlight? I want to get rid of that. Because I'll actually face these guys. What else we got? I think there's super mutants over there somewhere, if I remember correctly. I've played a lot of this game, if you can't tell. I think I have a couple days on this, actually.
Grip on yourself.
Hello, where are you? Oh, hello. Die! Who's throwing the Molotovs? Huh? Who is it? Whoop! I'm out. Let's just go over here to aid. Do that. Let's grill on a stick. And some, are these cooked? No, I don't think so. I don't think any of that's cooked. Great. Great! I got some bourbon. Ribeye steak. I'll deal with that. Where you at? Dude, you are a jerk. Can you not? And vegetables. Cool beans. Now we have it fine. Sure. I'll be out there in a second. Just grabbing all your stuff first. Actually, I think I just got a laser rifle, if I'm correct. Laser musket. Laser rifle. Sure. Let's do that.
I hope you like that. That was maybe by the ink spot. I mean, it was definitely
ink spot.
It's called maybe. I should have been clearer.
You got any more Molotovs there, guy? Yep. You had more Molotovs.
Me, Travis.
What a jerk.
Anyway, when someone named Big Maybell says there's a whole lot of shaking going on, you can probably believe. I mean, it's fair to say that's probably accurate. She's tremulous.
Attack! Come on, good boy. Give me a Redux, another stim pack, and we're gonna have some fun here. Anything equipped it on my grenades? Where you at? There's a mine. Yeah, there's my Molotovs. Alright. This is gonna be very risky. Oh, great. Dude, those hurt so bad. Just gonna sit here for a second. Will I know where I am? Oh, you suck. Technically, I suck, but... Oh, And of course, now I'm in a quick save that's right here. Alright, so I gotta use some stim packs so I don't move very slow. I'm in the fire right now. I'm in the heat of it all. Charge! Charge! Hey, come here. I'm gonna loot you up. You having fun down there? How you doing there, guy? Oh, dog! Crap. How do I submerge myself? There we go. I can't move! Why can't I move? Yeah, I can't move at all. This kind of sucks. I must have got like in a glitch or something. No. Swim. Can I actually swim? Is that really what I'm doing? Yeah, I'm about to die. Yep. Stupid glitch. Am I gonna face him again? Are you kidding me? Alright. This is why I don't face anyone with power without power armor on. It just takes so long. A dog! I'm taking so much drugs right now. What? You're kidding me. You're joshing me. I'm dealing so much damage. I hate getting into these loops. I hate being low level. Weapons. A double barrel shotgun. Alright, so now I'm gonna go to this. Two more of them. And then, oh, I can't quit now. What? For what? That's so lame. I guess. Try that out. Let's go back to my room. Dude, you suck so bad. Leave me alone. I need better armor, that's what I need. No way. Jerk? Who do you think you are? How many mod pods does this guy have? This is what I should have done in the first place. Come here! Die! You suck. Oh, and he used like a med pack or something. Finally, jeez. All right, quick save. For the dog. Woo! Took a while, but I got him. He only had one left. Well, wow. All right, I'm putting this spiked armor on. My armor sucks. Well, that sucks too. Hmm. Well, guess I'm just keeping what I got on. But I'm dying. Actually, I think they have a fire around here, don't they, that I can cook on? Most likely. Hello, where's the fire? You know, I should just heal myself just in case. You got anything? Take this submachine gun. You guys better have some good crap here. Oh! Cool. Waste more on my stim packs. Ooh, that's worth some money. Why do these guys like Molotov cocktails so much, huh? Don't let me fool you. That's not how you actually do it.
That's it.
Hey, you got them shotgun shells, though. Anything back here? Nope. Anything back here? I don't think so. Cool stuff. Alright. Parkour! Parkour, parkour! Ready? Ready for this? Dang it. How do you get up there? I'm not even gonna worry about it. I already got all the crap in there. Just need to get back up to the bridge. Alright, what's next? How far am I away from Diamond City? No one's over here? People are normally over here. Oh, there they are, I hear them. Oh, there's a hanging guy. That's nice. That means probably mutants are around somewhere. Pretty sure this is mutant territory. Run out of ammo here. him in the face. Hey. Sorry, I'll carry you guys. Oh, that was my kill. Oh, that didn't go very far. I like how big of a magazine this thing has. Give me all that on me. I can cook it up later. What's in here? A tibia. I don't think I want a tibia. You like how I'm just walking around while there's like a Fallout battle going on? Oh. Stupendous! I hate mines so much. I always get the power armor paint for explosives because I always end up stepping on mines. No, are you kidding me? Alright. So I know where everything is though, so I'm gonna grab it real right quick. Oh, there was a bomb there before. Good thing there wasn't one this time. Oh, this was a lockpick, wasn't it? Hey! You better work. Dang stairs. Oh, crap. Oh wait, what's that? Is that something? I don't think so. Alright. Lego! Did I grab all your crap? Yeah, I did. I'll let that recharge. I want to upgrade this one because it's got a big old capacity. I need to get used to saving more often. I die a lot more in VR than I do in actual Fallout. I'm much better with a controller. So we're just gonna quick save right here. Cook those.
If you're the kind of person who is tired of playing Diamond City,
run! Legendary enemy has mutated. Oh, I forgot about it again. Damn mines. I need like a bomb suit. That can be my armor. Just a bomb suit.
Thank you.
So, this radio station, we don't really make any attacks, and there are,
we're not playing with it this time.
Diamond City Surplus, now open 24 hours a day.
Oh, it's not there now.
Management reserves the right to refuse service to anyone, especially since this here,
back over here, yeah, there we go. Be careful. When they landed on Plymouth Rock, if today any cop should try to stamp, instead of landing on Plymouth Rock would land. Another one of them. Oh, there we go. Good job, guys. Good teamwork. I like how I don't remember if other games did this, but Fallout 4 will actually like events will happen even though you're not there too. Sometimes. I think. So I feel like sometimes I'm at certain places and things happen and I try to do it again. And they're not active anymore. Just like I said at that bridge, normally the super mutants are over there. And I don't remember seeing any people attacking them. We'll take that. Jump. I almost jumped over. Take that. Ooh. 34 damage. Nice. Yeah, I don't want that. You guys got anything else good? Huh? Hey. Got anything in the toilet? Ooh. Oh, nothing there. I thought that guy was alive for a second. We got a chest up here too. What's in here? Hey. Ooh. I like that. I just drop down in here? Yeah, I can. Now take those. Now take them. Oh, alright. I'll just go down this stairwell. I want to get to Diamond City. How far out am I? I can't be that far. Ooh, I'm almost there. I'm so close. Hello? Oh, I'm right here. Well, there's Piper. Alright, so I'm gonna save here. I think we're gonna call it quits. Gate. Cause I need food and things. Oh, those are quick saves. All right, so I want to save on that one. All right. All right. Hi, Piper. All right, guys. Thanks for watching the stream and stuff. If there's a game that you would like us to play or check out, you know, let us know. We will not be streaming tomorrow because it's Valentine's Day, and Maddie would kill me if I made her stream on Valentine's Day. So we won't do that, but we'll be back Thursday. And I think I'm going to try to work on getting Team Fortress 2 in VR. My cousin wants me to really do that, so we'll probably do that, or Doom VR or something like that. So, you know, just stay tuned. Get the notification, see what we're playing. But thanks for watching, guys.